I'm suggesting that as far as possible, schools should be organized under trees now. I recommend that we should even, as far as school children are concerned, that concept that we jettisoned, school under trees, we are in the dry season.
This is Ishao TV and welcome to GH Trending News. Now, Dr. Kwaku Afrieh of the MPP, former Minister of State of SIGA, has come out with an antidote with suggestion to control the spread of coronavirus. He said children should go to school under trees. Let's go and watch the video.
Look at the geographical distribution of COVID. You see that it is an urban phenomenon, even though there are sporadic cases in the rural settings. So that our approach should be that those areas that COVID has not touched, we should maintain them while we take care to deal with the situation in urban centers such as Accra and Kumasi and elsewhere. Mr. Speaker, even in Accra, it is very strange that places like Choko, Kore Bono and others, for some strange reason, those people are packed together and yet there's minimal spread. It is because of the outdoor life. Here, we are even here, we are saying that we are maintaining social distancing, but we are living in an enclosed capsule. And I'm suggesting that empirical thought, that because we have social distance ourselves and yet we have encased ourselves in this kind of casing, might not exactly be good for us. In this sense, I recommend that we should even, as far as school children are concerned, that concept that we jettisoned, school under trees, we are in the dry season. I'm suggesting that as far as possible, schools should be organized under trees now, because the body of empirical evidence suggests that when you stay in non-enclosed spaces, you don't get infected. That knowledge must be put to good use. In that wise, we are in a better place than those in temperate climates who are in winter time now. But Mr. Speaker, because I take at my seat, the last make of this maker, the MP for Ayawaso West Wogon, made some very, very succinct observation, which Africa, and for that matter, Ghana must take care of. This idea of what she called vaccine nationalism, it's a big phenomenon. It has always been around for a long time, as far as medicines are concerned. And I'm suggesting that as far as COVID-19 is concerned, it should goad us to think, get into the idea that indeed vaccines are security issues. In fact, Africa is harboring some of the worst pathogens that are left in this world. Neglected tropical disease, Borrelia ulcer, tuberculosis, the last vestiges of tuberculosis, Hansen's disease, that leprosy, and all those things are still around us. And even our good old malaria, we still don't have exactly a good handle on that. But all those medications and medicaments are coming not from Africa itself. Mr. Speaker, I suggest that we have the knowledge, we have the know-how, we have the capacity. It is only that we are not organizing ourselves well. So I'm advocating for a Pan-African approach, or at the very least an ECOWAS approach. Nigeria, Ghana, Senegal has the capacity to go into this vaccine development. And in double quick time, I believe that we can come out with something which might even surprise the world. After all, the very idea of vaccination emanated from Africa. Violation. Time was in the past when anybody who had smallpox, anybody who was recovering, convalescent patients, they took part of their plasma and they did scarifications, inserted it in them, and then they had a mild form of smallpox, and that was knowledge was taken by slaves to the Americas and Europe, and that was the beginning of vaccination. People do not know that. All this body of knowledge started from Africa, and we have a moral obligation to contribute to the body of knowledge in this world. Resource poor as we have, I don't think anybody is more intelligent. When God was distributing intelligence, he did it equitably. So let's get our act together. The capacity that we have, let's revamp them. Let's hold hands. Ghana, Nigeria, Senegal can get them. And task our scientists to do that. And when it comes to commercialization, I believe that the commercial people and the economists can make sure that we can move it from the realm of commercial activities so that we may not rely on the people who have medicalized, you know, diseases, especially tropical diseases, and reaping profit off us. Mr. Speaker, I didn't say that they have covered a lot of areas. So if I were to continue, I'm sure that I will end up giving up giving a letter. But suffice to say that COVID is providing a challenge. And I see that we can...
Wow, this is interesting. This is mind-blowing. This is thought-provoking. Now, from a typical perspective of MPP, they are going to say that this is a great idea, a good suggestion. Now, from the typical perspective of an NDC man, is also going to say that this is stupid, this is an unintelligent idea from the minister. Now, because the main idea is to get a better Ghana, to eliminate school under trees. And this idea is even going to encourage the government to ignore those children going to school under trees. Now, let's go and read some comments and reactions from Ghanaians. This message comes from Ma Itaya. She said, "And here, I thought we are alone in this. Ghana and Kenya, same WhatsApp group." All right. Flactard Brandful Ghana. He said, "You see stupidity? Because you are not capable of providing people with unit blocks, you are using your ignorance as an excuse." Yeah, that is what some people might think. Because the idea is to eliminate school under trees and provide a good education. All right. This message comes from Yao Boachi Yadom. He said, "It's very intelligent submission. We used to do it long ago when the weather is too hot for the people to be in classroom. But children can go to school in classrooms with air conditions." Right? Isn't it? DJ Blackman said, "Summertime Italy, they go to school in most of their gardens and outside campus to study with their teachers, with them." Yeah, that is true. So... that's why I'm saying some people might agree with him and some might not. Now, DJ Blackman again, he said, "In statement like this, he's supposed to say it in tree because he wanted to say a lot." Yes, he won, but you know, the official language for Ghana is English and the world is observing the parliament. So that's why they have to speak English. DJ Blackman also said again, "Very intelligent submission. The people will use it in politics. But this will be the best solution to the problem. Children can also stay home, but it's like they've stayed home for too long and it might come back to hurt them. So I think it's also a great idea." Now, this message comes from Hamza Dawood. He said, "If we could reminisce some years ago, schools under trees were classified as informal education. Are they now formal because of the uniforms the students are wearing?" Now, what do you think of what Dr. Kwaku Frie said? Do you agree with him or you totally disagree with him? Please consider liking the video, subscribing to my page and my channel for more. See you next time. Bye-bye.